welcome to this week's edition of Out of the Muhlenbubble. We're your hosts, Lizzie Cognini,
Julia Lowe,
and I'm Katie Mitchell.
So guys, this weekend wraps up the first weekend of Coachella.
Very
there were like
exciting.
Surprise guest performers were Kesha and Rihanna, which was really out of the box. So have you guys always wanted to go to Coachella? Is this just something I've always wanted to do?
No, I definitely want to go. I think it's this very glamorized world, and I just think it would be fun to experience it.
Yeah.
No, I totally get that. Actually, when you said Kesha was there, I'm going to be honest, I haven't heard about her in so long. That's kind of like, I'm not such a big Coachella person. I mean,
right.
I would go, that's so fun, but like, has she been in the scene lately, or is that
well,
just
you know
me?
The whole thing that happened with her...
And
the court case,
Luke.
And
guilty.
It's fine, but like.
But that's what's kept her out of the spotlight, and now she's
okay.
Kind of overcoming her troubles from her past. So this was, I think, one of her first appearances
yeah.
in a while. She's just kind of getting back into the swing of things.
It's good for her, though, just to get out and get some more exposure
mm-hmm.
and just do what she loves. Especially at like a cool thing like Coachella,
I was gonna say, yeah, exactly.
Which is basically just a hippie nowadays Woodstock.
It is like a modernized version of Woodstock.
But I was really satisfied with our quote unquote Berg-chella, which
so
was
fun.
Jeremiah coming Saturday night and then Jesse McCartney performing Sunday, and there was food, a bouncy castle, people
so
really dressed up and hippie like. So did you guys like that?
I mean, I thought it was fun. I went to both of them, and it was the Jeremiah concert was so fun. Like.
Yeah.
I got the drumsticks, which was so fun. I went up to the drummer, I was like, hey, can I get your drumsticks? And he gave them to me. I was like, okay, bye. Like, thanks so much. And then Jesse McCartney, I have to say, like, beautiful soul, great song. I grew up listening to
beautiful
that stuff,
song.
So just hearing it, his new songs I didn't know so much about.
Mm-hmm.
It was just so interesting, and like, to hear it and everyone being together,
and
especially, it was so hot outside, like,
right.
to be
the weather was
outside
beautiful.
And stuff.
I also feel like the way that the social media around this whole weekend at Muhlenberg was kind of was like our own Coachella in a way, because we saw like Jesse McCartney's Snapchat story. It was like him walking to the stage.
Yeah,
that was
so
kind of weird. But it's definitely awesome. Like, I mean, the fact that he like talked about how he's transitioning to TV now and everything. Just like
it
kind of personal.
8-year-old me was very happy.
Yeah.
No, and when he said he was 29, I was like, wait, what? Come here? Like, it's just been so long that you haven't
you don't
done
realize
it.
How much time has passed.
So,
honestly.
So crazy. I'm a freshman in college. Like, that's weird. Like,
yeah.
to see someone that I was growing up with
right.
and now he's 29, I was like, what happened?
I think it was all in all, awesome weekend.
Yeah.
For Coachella and for the Berg.
Yeah.
Julia,
exactly.
Do you have any news for us?
Yeah,
what's going on?
So many of you might know her from the hit TV show Glee, Santana Lopez, who was the cheerleader. Nea Vieira was actually discussing on E! She was in Fit Pregnancy and Baby
mm-hmm.
magazine, and she came out with her 8-month-old baby boy, and I was thinking, like, is that exposure? She even discussed it, coming out with her baby, whether or not that was okay, but she said, like, it's something to look back on. What do you guys think about that, having a son, especially that young, go on a cover of a magazine?
Personally, I'm just a tiny bit over the whole idea that I had a baby, I'm a celebrity, I'm gonna parade it on magazine covers like a trophy. Like, we get it. A lot of women have babies, and I also almost think it's a little bit bad for some women because they come out, like celebrities like Nia Rivera, and she's like, look, I had a baby, and I'm fit now, and I'm beautiful. And whether you lose the baby weight or not, it's not that important. You just, like, had a child. I don't
right.
think it has to be on a magazine cover.
I think the only, I guess, positive part about it is that it's on a Fit Baby magazine and
true.
Not something else that's so well-known, like
People
or Glamour or something like that, that you would read because it's this, like, glamorized magazine. But it is interesting just because, like, you don't know how your child is going to grow up, and that definitely has an effect on them,
mm-hmm.
whether you realize it or not in the moment. So
right.
it's interesting.
And she actually goes into discussing the challenges of being a mom, which is interesting, again, going into the point of, like, do you need to be so public about it? Okay, you're in Hollywood, so that's public as it is. But discussing the challenges of being mom, many people could relate to that, but it's actually interesting. Going into other news,
mm-hmm.
Kate Hudson came out on E! About how open she was with her family. And as we were discussing before, how having a mom, a dad, a brother, everyone in her family is in the Hollywood world, how that is to be so out there with everything. And she actually had her, she spoke about her kids and how they've been out there a little bit. Like, what do you guys think about having your children, again, an 8-month-old baby. Kate Hudson has a 12-year-old and a 4-year-old. What do you guys think about that?
I think that it's good because she's trying to keep her family grounded. And, I mean, I just think all of these, everyone's just a person at the end of the day. And with, like, Kate Hudson's family, yes, she comes from a line of fame, but she's a normal person who other people happen to know. So it's kind of interesting to look at it from that perspective because it's like you still want to bring your family up well and you want to give them a solid foundation. And I guess that's what she's trying to do by keeping this open communication among them.
Yeah, but also there's, I think, a negative, just to count your opinion, with being too open. That, like you said before, these are kids. Maybe they don't want to be in the spotlight.
Right.
And honestly, just having them always be in the spotlight, following around by paparazzi, even their, like, the little kids' friends at school probably know everything about their family, and that's gotta hurt them, whether that's, like, self-esteem or just being open. Because I know when I was growing up, just growing up and going through puberty was hard enough. Imagine the whole world watching you.
Yeah. I hope in her open communication, she's kind of trying to counteract all of that publicity that they're getting and, you know, making them level-headed individuals.
Well, that's
one would hope.
Exactly. No, well, that's a struggle because a lot of the times it's talked about in the media, like, you know what you're getting yourself into. I'm sure with Miley Cyrus, I remember even reading things about that. Like, she's going through struggles and claims, okay, the media's all about, like, looking at me. But at the end of the day, you are getting yourself into this world. So I feel like
you kind of have to expect that.
Justin Bieber also, with all of the things, oh, I'm just trying to be a normal guy. Okay, but at the same time, you got yourself into this position.
You chose the industry.
Exactly.
Not to undermine the fact that it can become overwhelming, but I mean,
no,
and maybe they realize they can't handle it once they're at that point, but it is something that you know you're signing up for and getting yourself into. So.
Yeah.
No, I definitely get that. And do you have some news?
Yeah, so in television news, this is very exciting. Disney Channel is going to have a 4-day special where they air 51 of their Disney Channel original movies. This is actually in celebration of their 100th original movie that's coming out called Adventures in Babysitting, which I can't believe there has been 100 movies. I was looking at the schedule, and some of my favorites on the list, like Camp Rock, Eddie's Million Dollar Cook-Off, Cadet Kelly, they're all on there, and I'm like, gotta set my DVR.
I'm
but
so,
are you guys excited?
I'm so excited. I'm probably going to become a hermit
for those days
where I just, like, sit myself in my room 100%. Surrounded by, like, popcorn soup and everything.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait to see Xenon.
Yeah, I know.
And then, of course, all of the, like, movies where, like, on a birthday you turn into something. So
right.
Like, Luck of the Irish, where he turns into a leprechaun, or the
13th
year, where he turns into a mermaid.
That's great. It's funny because I was thinking about this before. Like, a lot of kids now are looking. I mean, I don't really keep up with the new singers, I'll be honest.
Mm-hmm.
But it's interesting. Like, what do you guys think about having these shows when we were children? I feel like
I think that all of these channels are trying to bring in, like, a wider demographic in a way, because these Disney Channel movies that they're airing are ones that we grew up with. So it's going to bring in a lot of college-age kids who, like, wouldn't normally be watching the channel anymore, just as Nickelodeon is doing with, like, bringing back all their 90s shows and, like, their All That reunion. Like, it seems to be a trend going on, but I mean, I think it's cool because I think it's a way to get people re-interested in watching television as opposed to, like, streaming things.
It's a good marketing ploy, but I also feel very aged.
Yeah, that's
true.
I remember that 10 years ago.
That's what I'm saying, when we were kids. When we were kids.
It'll definitely be nostalgic. But in other TV news, did you hear that Michael Strahan is actually leaving Live with Kelly and Michael?
I heard about that.
He's becoming
an
anchor on Good Morning America.
Oh.
So, I mean, Live with Kelly and Michael will be looking for a new co-host.
I guess I
And he was actually a correspondent on Good Morning America since 2014, and I guess they just loved his viewpoints, thought he was very versatile, so they're bringing him on full-time, which is amazing considering GMA is one of the leading morning news shows.
Yeah, that's crazy. I mean, just thinking about him switching news industry, what do you guys think about that? Like, if you were on a show, like one of the ones he was on, and then switch to another, like, is that
you're both ABC, so he's still on the same network, and it's daytime at the same time. I mean, Live with Kelly Michaels, more daytime than morning news, but it's cool to see him transition.
Right, it'll be interesting to
see
the way
he... Or that it's just weird that he's leaving and he's one of the names.
Yeah,
on the title.
I guess we'll see what happens with that, but...
Yeah, definitely.
That's all that we have in store today for your entertainment news. Thanks for watching, Muhlenberg. Catch you later.
Have a great weekend.
Bye.